You know, you could say plenty about how resilient the people down here really are, how tough they have been in the face of disaster. But toughness only goes so far. And now after Katrina, the recession, and now this, many have reached the limits of resilience. A Gulf fishing boat captain took his life recently, and no one can be sure of why. You never really know. But the spill took his livelihood, and the fear is he won't be the last. We saw a spike in mental health issues after the Exxon Valdez disaster, and local professionals say they are seeing the same thing now. BP promises to make things right on the Gulf, but the $10 million question tonight is, can they, will they make this right? Randi Kaye takes us up close.
When Louisiana's health secretary sent this letter to BP last week requesting $10 million in funding for mental health, he expected a speedy answer, days at most. This is what he told us last week.
You know, that's one of the reasons why we put a deadline on the letter. If you notice the last sentence, we said we need an answer by next week.
But that deadline has come and gone. No answer from BP. And this was the state's second request for $10 million. BP responded to the first request saying it, quote, looked forward to continuing the dialogue, but the oil giant provided nothing.
The money, if it ever comes, would be used to treat those experiencing emotional trauma since the spill. Fishermen like Lewis Lund Jr., who can no longer fish to support his family because of the oil. His wife says he's full of rage.
He wants to go on a rampage, screaming, punching, hitting, whatever he can do, and he can't. And he just can't get it out. It's just stuck in there, bubbling.
And how's that anger coming out?
It comes out. He started drinking. He's smoking more when we're trying to quit. He takes it out on us just in general. We do something that kind of would make him upset, and all the other stresses kind of pile on top of that, so he blows up.
Rachel Morris wants to help. She's learning how to navigate the emotional pressures at group wellness classes like this one at the St. Bernard Project. Other Gulf wives are here too. Same problem.
I've got one at home right now that needs to vent, you know, but won't. He'll fuss at me or he'll fuss at him and or the kids.
Among other things, the group is taught breathing exercises to control stress.
Push the air out to release all that negativity from your body.
The project's CEO, Zach Rosenberg, says if BP doesn't pay, this lifeline will end for many. They won't have enough money to treat everyone. Even now, it's far from ideal. Those anxious, angry, or depressed already have to wait 8 weeks just to get in for a first appointment.
Is this wellness group an example of why you need more money from BP?
If we are able to get more dollars in the door, going to start a peer-to-peer counseling program. We're going to add evening and weekend hours to our center, and we're going to open a satellite office down the road because the need is clearly there.
We tried to contact BP numerous times to ask why it hasn't even responded to the state's latest request. No one at BP responded to us either.
Does it surprise you that BP hasn't come forward with the $10 million to help people like your family that the state has requested?
No, I don't think, it's not surprising to me. I don't think that they're doing nearly what they could do. I don't expect to see the $10 million because they don't care about us. We're an inconvenience to them.
An inconvenience and perhaps just another expense in BP's $3 billion tab in the Gulf. Randi Kaye, CNN, New Orleans.
All right, and we're digging deeper now with Dr. Almar Rigmer. He's medical director of Catholic Charities right here in New Orleans. Thanks so much for joining us.
Nice to be here. Thank you.
You know, we've said it before, but, you know, Hurricane Katrina, the recession, now this. You're seeing lots of patients, more than 3,000, I understand.
We have five centers in the communities, the affected communities. And so far in these centers, we've seen about 14,000 people for various needs, financial needs, some guidance, and some for counseling. BP is financing this work, incidentally. We opened up there right when this began, about a few days after this began, at the request of the parish pastors. And when BP saw what they were doing, they asked could they help out. So they gave us a big sum of money in the beginning to start this, and so we're operating on that now.
So they came to you?
They came to us. They came to us, and they also asked us to get together a group of organizations here. They're the voluntary organizations active in disasters, a collaborative of 30 not-for-profits working in the area, in the communities, run by people in the communities. So this is a coalition of organizations. We've come together, and BP asked us to propose a grant to operate for the next 3 months, giving mental health assistance.
What sort of things do you expect to see? Valdez?
Well, we're seeing the Valdez studies bear out here, really. We're in the early phase right now. And the difference between Valdez or Katrina is that this is ongoing, and that's a continuous pressure. But we're seeing what you would expect. People feel very anxious, very afraid. They don't know what's going to happen to their livelihood, their community. There's beginning to be depression and a real sense of helplessness, because these are people who are working, and then within a week, you know, not only are they not working, but they got to deal with the legal system and corporate system and case managers and whatnot to get back to work.
From a mental health perspective, given that it's ongoing people are having a lot of the symptoms you just described, what can you do about it?
I think we can do a lot. First of all, we're doing a lot of education about what reactions to expect, anticipatory guidance. So if you have these kinds of reactions, you're not mentally ill, you're having normal reactions to this terribly abnormal event. We want you to come in and talk to us, and we're fanned out in the communities to do that. We're following the model, much like we did after Katrina, where you go out into the communities and seek people out. So we're doing that, hiring people in the communities to do that. And then with all of this fanning out and screening and talking to people, we'll talk to ones or screen many, many people to see who needs to be kicked up to the next level and talk a little more about it.
Okay. For somebody who's watching right now who may think, you know, I feel like maybe I should be getting help, how do they know that they should be seeing someone like you, and how do they know that it could be something quite serious?
Well, usually when it's quite serious, they see somebody like me as a psychiatrist, but not many have to come up to me, really. I think that if they have persistent negative thoughts, they just can't get rid of them. There's a feeling that nothing will go right, everything I tried or everything I will try, it won't matter. If it's spilling over into your family and you're irritable and you're picking on your kids or you're arguing with your wife, usually it's the husband who's the primary wage earner in these communities, and you're just feeling down, I think that's one thing. Certainly, if you feel that, you know, life is not worth living and it's too hard to go on, and I've been through Katrina and I had a setback in the recession, still going on, and right. Now I got this, you should talk to us.
Not just here in New Orleans or in this area of the country, but all over the country, people have really felt the impact of this. And I think, again, because it is ongoing, 2.5 months
right.
Now, no end in sight.
No end in sight.
Any advice for people who are just watching night after night?
I'd limit what I watch. This is, you know, a continuous stimulus, reworking this over and over and over again. And we certainly tell that to people here. You know what's going on, but get,
you know,
your mind off something else.
News, you know.
Keep up on the news for all you need to know, but only what you need to know, really. I don't think regurgitating it over and over and over and over with all of the nuances are very helpful. And certainly if you're preoccupied with it, like a lot of people here, they need some time out of this and away from this. And that's one of the things we try to get them to do. The most important thing we want these people to do, the ones here, is to have a sense of mastery, once again, of what's going on in their lives and get back to work and help them do what they
all
need
right.
to do.
All
take
right.
over.
Dr. Rigmer, thanks so much
thanks
for joining
for
us.
Me.
Appreciate
okay.
it. We're certainly going to try and keep people informed on this very issue, including the paper trail that led to this. Evidence that federal regulators in charge of protecting the fish and wildlife, well, they dropped the ball. We're going to follow the facts on that, keeping them honest. And later, Chad Myers on the new threat to the cleanup from the weather. Stay with us.